Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the James Wan Sports Center, the Lita Andrews Court. What a classic tonight. Your Granbury Lady Pirates taking on our neighbors right down the road, the Glenrose Lady Tigers, and my very special guest, one of the all-time greats in Lady Pirate volleyball history, the great Jessica Wunderlich Burke. I got that in.
Thank you so much for inviting me out. This is great. I just love coming out and watching these girls and really supporting them. It really makes my week.
It certainly does. It's a great time to be out here, great atmosphere. And I tell you, Jessica, the people from Glenrose over here to support their girls, this is great. These two little communities, big difference in size, but yet we should do this all the time.
Absolutely, yes. And this will make for a great atmosphere just to play and hear everybody yelling and hollering just for both teams. It's going to be a great night.
Now, you remember quite well your student section. These kids over here are massive. They're smart. They know what to call, and they know how to be obnoxious.
That's great. Yeah, to see that big of a crowd to come out and support our ladies, it's really amazing to see. And it's awesome to just have that support, not only from your family and your community, but also from your friends. To see your friends up there, it's just something awesome to see.
And of course, I was noticing football guys are all here. They got their practices over with. Of course, Coach Galindo wanting them to be here and be a part of it. So it's wonderful to see all the sports here supporting it. It's the way it should be.
Absolutely.
Let's do this. Going to be a fun one tonight. Lady Pirates are going to be opening district play on the 1st. They're going to be traveling to Cleburne, and that's when it all starts. Tournament season is over, and Jessica, I know you couldn't wait for that when you played.
It is a lot mentally and physically for those girls and for the coaches. But once you get into district play, that's just when all you can open up and really dig in and just really start to have some fun.
Absolutely. All right. Now, this is some good old school stuff right here now. I can dig that. Jump around.
Yeah, I know we were talking about that before the game. Yeah. Really enjoying the selection on this playlist.
Well, my man Jason Shahan is running the music down there. Well, that's a good thing. All right, Lady Pirates, of course, starting tonight. Kylie Moody out there, number 11. Sienna Watts, number 10. Number 7 out there is Addie Cowling. She's one of the starters. Number 17, of course, is Allison McCabe. And Rachel Poirier, number 12. Of course, our libero, Lily McCall in the green jersey. And we're going to try to get a little recognition to the Glenrose girls as we can. You can see number 14, Flippin. I would have her starting, too. She's 6'4". Here we go. McCabe will serve. They'll set this up for Flippin. Wow.
I think that was over the block right there.
I have a feeling we're going to see that a lot tonight.
Well, you know, they did actually work on a lot of their blocks this week. And so closing the block and their defense around the block as well. So hopefully they're able to learn some from that this week.
This one comes to Rachel. It's going to be back all the way over. McCabe will set it up. It'll go to McCall. Poirier, excuse me. That was Sienna Watts. Sienna leading the team in kills to this point. Number 5, Evans. Number 12 for Glenrose is Gray. We'll get the rest as we go. Serve comes from Rachel. Set this one up again. Good one by McCabe. McCall's got it. Going to take the Bleeker. Met by Glenrose, going to be set up by Gray, back over. Comes to Poirier. Flippin got a hand on that one. Libero Number 7, Anderson, set this one up. Bleeker got it happening.
She really powered through that block and was able to get a touch on that.
2-1 Lady Pirates here. Of course, best 3 out of 5 as we're playing here tonight. Send that one all the way back over to McCall. Going to be set up again. Sienna! Sienna started as a freshman. And she's going to have some records by the time she gets out of here.
I can just tell she's been working hard.
Set this one up. Other side it goes. McCabe got under it. McCall will take it over to Bleeker. Bleeker puts it down.
You know, earlier we were talking about how it's nice to have that lefty on that right side that can just really blow it away as soon as it comes out of the setter's hands.
And confusing to the other team. I mean, that's got to be tough. Rachel serving again, 4-1, Lady Pirates set to flipping. Wow. She placed that rather well. I see Glen Rose has even got their own student section, too.
You know, being right down the road has its perks. Maybe we can do the same for Cleburne.
Got to do it now. Got to do it. Serve comes in a 4-2 game. It is out. Lady Pirates 5-2.
I liked how we got our toes to the line to really watch that ball go out of bounds. You just never know. You got to watch it go all the way out.
It's tempting. Yep. I guess. Never been there, but you have.
Yes.
Set this one up. Other side. Good one sent in there. That was Arrington with the kill for Glen Rose. 5-3 game, and Flippin will go back to serve.
That was good on McCall to get a hand on it, though. Don't let it touch the floor.
That was a tough one to get to. Set up. Watts pushed back. Sienna got her another one. Blum will come into the lineup along with Johnson. Peyton Johnson, one of our homecoming queen candidates.
Ooh, congratulations.
That's already next week.
It's going to be hot, but it's going to be a fun game at the same time.
Yep. Put over by the Lady Pirates. I'll set this one up. Just the tip. Bleeker got a hand on it. Johnson sends it back. Whoa. Arrington's a strong player. That had some heat on it.
She really brought it that time. She really did.
6-4 the score. Arrington serves, tipped the net. Set it by Blum to Bleeker. Anderson set it up, the ball tipped over. Watch, Johnson with a tip. Glen Rose answers. Anderson sets it, the long one. Get backwards, McCall answers it. Blum will send it over. Set up at the front. Another deep one. Booth with that kill. And it's a 6-5 game. I'd like to welcome all of our viewers tonight, Granbury and in Glen Rose. Tipped up by Poirier. Bleeker again. Oh, man.
That's a leader right there, trying to kill that run and bring it back for us to get that service. Ball's in our court now.
And I tell you another thing about that one right there, Jessica, is how she could have gone straight on, but she could have angled it
right
away from her blockers. Sienert with the kill that time for Glen Rose, and it's 7-6. Great crowd tonight on both sides. Love seeing this. McCall with it. Blum will set it up. It goes to Johnson, pushes it over. Arrington sets it. Another kill in for Senert. She's got two in a row. 7-7. Yeah, I know that looking forward to a volleyball season in Glenrose, but the Lady Tiger basketball team, we'll get to it in a second. Ball sent over by Kylie. Back over. Johnson has it.
Let's get it.
Blum's going to set it. Not quite enough. But the Lady Tiger basketball team got beat in the state championship game last year.
Wow.
And their whole team is coming back. So.
Well, that's great to have everybody coming back from a state championship. Yeah. Man, that's going to be fun to look out for.
Blum will set this up for Rachel. Tipped at the net. Out of bounds off of Glenrose, and we're tied at 8.
Seems like Glenrose has a pretty strong block, but it's nice to see our team really work out those abs and swing hard through that block.
Kylie Moody with the serve. That's a tough one to handle. Able to get it back. Great play on the return. Blum chipped over that time by Cowling. Oh, mercy. Just enough. Boy, I tell you, number three, Seinert, since she has been in, she's been pretty active. Three quick points. 9-8 Glenrose. Game one at the James Wan here. Blum is going to set this up on the side. Rachel back to get it as Anderson. And the ball tipped over the net. Those have got to be tough to handle when they come off the net like that.
Oh, absolutely. It's hard to react, but you really got to get on your balls or your feet, and you're not knowing where that ball is going to go.
10-8, Glenrose. Anderson serving. Set this one up. Cowling!
Very nice.
10-9, side out Lady Pirates. McCabe back in the lineup for Granbury, along with Sienna Watts.
All right, let's go, girls.
Set this up. Ball tip. That was out off of Flippin.
Trying to go around our big block.
Absolutely. Glenrose block.
There's that big
Pirates.
Block.
Sienna Watts, big block. Lady Pirates with three straight to take the lead back 11-10. McCabe with the serve. Ball tipped over. McCall takes to Rachel. Ball tip. Rachel Poirier.
Here we go, girls.
With another one. Lady Pirates 12-10 now.
Let's keep it rolling.
Nice comeback for the girls.
I notice McCabe is a pretty accurate server as well.
Yes, she is. Very good. Flipping up and over. Digging deep for that, but not enough, and Granbury's got another one. Granbury 13-10 now. McCabe, another strong serve. Flipping, blocked back.
They timed it well. It was just angled out a little bit.
13-11 is now our score. Set this one up. Sienna Glenrose able to handle it. Anderson sent back by Arrington. And out. 13-12. Granbury Park football is going to be on the road on Friday at Lake Worth, as well as the Lady Pirates on the road in Cleburne. Set up. Harrington with the push. McCall. McCabe. Oh, nice job. I love those, and kind of a little no look.
Right. You have to be on the lookout for that as a setter, when, and smart on when to do that exactly. You know who used to be great at that was Michael Slimmons back in my day.
Oh, yes. Mikey. We're going to get her up here, I guarantee you that.
Oh, absolutely. That's a must.
Never mind.
You know, it seems like before Flippin was kind of trying to be smart about her placement,
yeah.
But that had some power behind it.
Yes, it did. Harrington with the serve back to Bleeker. We'll take it over to Sienna. Jumping up high to get that one. Gray. Harrington again. That's a pretty good 1-2 punch up there with number 10 and 14 for Glenrose. 14 all. Serve comes from Glenrose. Knuckler, great return by the ladies, the way that started. Harrington again. Wow.
You know, mad respect to her for coming out to play.
Yes.
Right to start off. Sometimes it's hard to get going just like that, so full respect to her for that.
Ain't no doubt. 15-14, Glenrose in the lead. Set this one up for Bleeker. In the net.
We'll take that.
That ties it up at 15 here in game one. McCall with the serve. Set this one up. Other side blocked by the Lady Pirates. But Glenrose plays it. Sent it back. Come to McCabe. McCabe to Watts. Harrington not enough. Granbury 16-15.
Our blocks were ready that go round. You know, with blocks, it's not all about just jumping up in the air, but you have to time with your blocking partner as well.
Set up here. Sienna has it blocked. Glenrose recovered off of that one. Send it back. Got it done. Wow. 16 all. Got a little friendly competition going on between student sections.
Like we said before, that's always great to see.
That's it. Flipping with the serve. Watts with a big strong but returned by Glenrose. Harrington to McCall. Set up over here for Bleeker. Back at her. Glenrose. Set up, McKay. Bleeker with a tip. Well, I'm not somebody in the net, but Bleeker with a great shot right down the line. And we've tied it at 17. Jessica, I hope you plan for a long evening.
Hey, I welcome it with volleyball.
I know you do.
We're in the AC. It's great athletic ability. Let's go.
Let's do it. Heck yes. Give me an ace. Lady Pirates up now 18-17. Blum back to serve for Granbury. Return comes. McCall takes it to Bleeker. Bleeker across. Got it done. Bleeker with her fourth of the night. And Granbury up by two. Glen Rose will take a timeout. I was beginning to wonder if somebody's going to take a timeout. It's wearing me out up here.
You know, for the other team to call a timeout first, that's always a good sign.
Absolutely. All right, tell me about it. Graduated Granbury High School. What a great career you had on the college. Now you're back teaching in G-Town. Tell me about it.
I am. I'm out at Acton Middle School, actually.
That's awesome.
And I'm loving it. I was in Fort Worth ISD, great place, but the commute kind of took me away from my family, and so I really wanted to come back home and just be with people that I actually graduated with, went to school with, and to be a Granbury Pirate again.
That's awesome, Jessica. Great to have you back in the fold. Sir from Blump. Long, a little too much, 19-18. Serve coming from Gray here. No, excuse me, that's Arrington on the serve for the Lady Tigers. Into the net. Hey, we'll take a service error to another.
Right?
Dig that.
All right, no more though, no more.
20-18. This is Tammy's favorite time of the game when you reach 21st.
It sure is. Yep. Let's go. Five more. Yeah.
Well, there's one of them. Give me another ace. Blum continues on serving here. Gives another one. Blum taking care of business right now. 22-18, Lady Pirates trying to finish out this game one. Set it up, far side, hammer down. Sainert with the kill, making it 22-19. Back to serve is Bunt. Set it up for Poirier. Nice save by Glen Rose to keep that one playing. Blum to McCall. McCall back to Rachel again. Arrington will set it up. The return comes. Block and off of Granbury. Sinert again. 22-20.
Making adjustments in the service receive.
Moody on that one. That was a deep one. Johnson not able to get it there. Blocked at the net, and it's 22-21. Been like this all night, back and forth.
We're making another adjustment on that service receive. We can break it right here, ladies. Let's go.
Rachel Blum back the other side to Johnson. Same results. Well, you know, it never fails. When the team calls it, it shuts down the mo, and that's obvious right there.
Right. And I could see what Blum was trying to do there. She was over on the left side, and she was trying to catch the blockers off guard and really do like a deep back set back to Johnson. But Glen Rose was ready. Glen Rose was ready.
They were. Well, folks, next week, hard to believe, but it is homecoming week in Granbury. That just it comes too fast. I like the later in the season for homecoming, but ever since the COVID years, they've all been moved up.
Interesting.
I
didn't even notice that.
Yeah.
I like the chillier moment those nights too.
Yeah, those
cozy hot chocolate.
Serve coming up from Glen Rose. Blum will set this up. It goes to Rachel. Down the line and in.
That was a beautiful pass, set, and kill.
Oh, what a finish.
You can kind of just feel behind that beautiful set. And, I mean, you just hope and pray that that left side, she's got it behind her. Or not the ball, but she's got that power behind her.
Moody with the serve. 23-22. Nice save by Blum. Ball sent over by Poirier. Arrington will set this up. Johnson got it. Back to Rachel again. Arrington sets the return. A dig by Moody. Great play, but they answered on the return. Blum again. Moody. Moody takes it to Johnson. Pushes it over. Glen Rose again. Block and out. Wow. I hate the outcome, but what a volley.
Yes. That was a great, great shot by Johnson. But again, Glen Rose was scrappy.
Yes, they are.
They brought it back.
23-23. Ball set up for Blum. Ball tipped in the corner. Oh, there you go.
That was a nice, strong tip. Normally when you see those fingers, you think it's going to go short.
Yep.
So that was smart on her part as well, really shooting that ball back.
Saw that open corner over there, took advantage of it. Great shot by Cowling. This is game point. McCabe with the serve. Return comes from Sainert. McCabe. Saved by Anderson. Ball tipped over. In the net. And Granbury is going to take number one. 25-23. Wow.
That game should really pump up the girls.
Ain't no doubt about it. What a great game by both teams.
Yes.
Game two going to be coming up. We'll be back. Jessica Burke joining me tonight. Fun times in Granbury. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Game number two. Wow. Jessica, that was incredible, that first game. 2-point difference, Granbury 25-23.
Really makes you excited to watch some volleyball.
Here we go again. Of course, switch sides between. Nice way to start things off is senior Rachel Poirier. Poirier, McCall, McCabe, Bleeker, Watts, and Cowling out on the floor to start this game too for the Lady Pirates. Back to Anderson, set this one up to Flippin. Good recovery that time by Bleeker. We'll set it up again, other side. That one goes down. Arrington ties it at one. Back serving is Gray, Bleeker, McCall. Watts gets it over. Set this one up for Flippin. And that was out. Thing had just had too much juice on him. Wow.
Just thankful our girls didn't get a touch on that one.
No kidding. Set this one up, Arso. Blocked back by Granbury, and it's 3-1.
Nice single block there.
You know, you mentioned your blocking partner. You know, at times it's hard to see who gets the block when you got a block. Something I wouldn't want to decipher.
Well, that's some of the other coaches' jobs. Let them worry about that.
That's exactly. Long one on the return. The ball was tipped at the net by Granbury. Side out goes to Glen Rose, and it's 3-2 Granbury.
You know, it's typically the outside's job to line up the block, and the middle come out, really close that block up for the team.
Flipping on the serve here. Set this one up. Bleeker blocked back, but Granbury recovers. Not able to get that one down.
It's good to see some block defense like that. We obviously know that Glenrose brought some big blocks. So now we need to get ready for that ball, not to just go over, but sometimes to bounce back and let's pop it right back at them.
Absolutely. Flipping with another serve. 3-3 the score. McCabe, whistle blown. Must have had a lift. I'm not sure.
It did look a little off. Maybe she a lift or a double. It kind of went a little bit back.
Okay. Glenrose takes their first lead in this second game. Kylie Moody ties it right back up. Blum comes back in now to serve for the Lady Pirates. She had a great service run towards the end of game number one.
She had a good game, all around.
Blum. Ball set up, tipped over.
We ready.
Bleeker, yes, ma'am. Bleeker on top tonight for the Lady Pirates now with 5 kills. Blum will serve again. Glenrose on the return. Not enough.
Moody was ready right there.
Granbury 6-4 now. Blum to serve again. Set up. Return. Good job by McCall to save that one. We'll take it to Bleeker again, but saved by Anderson. Well.
Looked like Glenrose was in the net.
7-4, Granbury by 3 here. There you go.
They're saying it back.
I love it. Long one, it is out.
Wait, what?
Well.
I think they called the whistle right before, so maybe that
okay.
threw her off.
All right.
We'll take it.
We dodged, absolutely.
We'll take it.
We dodged one on that one now.
She's pretty consistent, though. She can bring this ball in.
So by Blunt. Set this one up. Sent over by Glen Rose. That was weights.
That ball must have had topspin on it because it looked like it wasn't going over, and then it just inched its way.
Had some English on it, didn't I? I'm telling you. Is that your clone? I mean, your daughter?
Yes. Abby's with me enjoying this volleyball.
Heck yes. I bet she might be playing.
Blinker. Oh, yeah.
Glen Rose saves it. Ball pushed on over by Gray. Going to set up. Blum. Glen Rose returns.
Use this free ball.
McCall to Blum to Bleeker. That's Granbury. That was chipped at the net. Bleeker having a great game tonight.
You know, my daughter is in sixth grade, but she can't wait till next year.
Oh, I can imagine.
That means Granbury sports.
Glen Rose sets it up. Blocked by the Lady Pirates. Good job. That's Moody and Poirier on that block combo. 9-5 Granbury.
Nice, strong teamwork.
Set up the tip over that time. Blum back a little bit, but McCall recovers. Johnson finishes. Set up Glen Rose. Ball pushed across by Waits. Waits with a couple of points here in this one. 9-6 now the score.
And it looked like the timing was off with the set and the hit, but she was able to bring it over. That was good on her part too. No,
served by Bunt. Blum. You're just not much you can do with those when they go into the net like that.
Right. And she can't jump because she's in the back. Otherwise, it'd be counted as a back row hit.
Right.
Or, yeah. So that's kind of tricky. Sometimes you just have to wait for the ball to roll down.
Johnson will return. Has it blocked. McCall. Great finish that time by Petchel. Well, Glen Rose, Booth. Puts it over, and it's 9-8.
Good pass.
Moody, saved by Glen Rose. Anderson gets it over. Long one. Anderson again. McCall sets this one up for Johnson. It's there. Set up far side. McCall again. We'll take this to Rachel. Back line, Glen Rose. Push it up. Blum. McCall. McCall to Rachel again. Has it blocked, but a save by Moody.
Good defense.
Blum finishes. Anderson sets. Block Granbury. Save Glen Rose. At the net again. Wow.
You gotta love a good volley.
Isn't that crazy?
But you gotta get the points.
Well, we got ours. They got it in the first game. We got the great volley. Oh,
that's right.
What a play right there. Anderson set up. Pulled down by Booth. Right back at it.
Yep, that's the way to answer it. You gotta come on strong after a good volley like that.
Anderson will serve for the Lady Tigers. Set up by Granbury. Not enough on that one from Cowling. And we are tied at 10. Rachel goes out of bounds to get that one. Calling will finish it. Anderson are going to set this one up. Tip and in the corner.
You know, that was a pretty good play on Glen Rose. The middle hitter came in, and then the left side came right behind her.
Oh.
So that throws off the blocks. You don't know if it's going to be a shorter set
right.
or a higher set for the back person. So that was good on Glen Rose.
11-10, Glen Rose has jumped into the lead. Rachel Poyer ties it.
All right, here we go.
11-11, Lady Pirates back to serve. It will be McCabe again. Good serve by McCabe as usual. Block, save, and out. Lady Pirates back in the lead. McCabe to serve again here.
Nice streamline serve.
Set this one up for flipping. McCall gets it. Ball pushed over. Anderson digs for that one. Back on the back line. Saved by Glen Rose. Set up. McCall. Calling. Back to McCabe. Pushed over by Glen Rose. Here they go again. Block. Wow. Sienna didn't like that. Twelve. They're back at it again. Granbury sets it up. Once again, it's Watts. That one worked. Sienna with her fourth of the night. Lady Pirates back in the lead. Once again, just like game one, it's back and forth.
You know, and it seemed like Anderson from Glen Rose really absorbed that hit, that strong hit, really well.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure exactly what happened there.
Served by Granbury. Anderson sets it up close to the line. Oh, my goodness.
That was a beautiful setup from the back row. I mean, props to the hitter. Props to the hitter, but that setup from the back row, it was Anderson, right?
Yes.
There, that was beautiful.
That was,
good on them.
That was incredible.
Let's go, Granbury, though. Come on, we got this.
Back at 13 now. Bleeker, back it goes. She'll have to get it again. Just over. Set up to flipping, and it's long.
That was a strong fee ball, I guess you could say. Getting that over.
They're fighting for a tip right there, but didn't get one.
No.
Granbury back up 14-13.
Looks like Granbury's trying to just figure out their rotation just real quick.
Moody back in the lineup, and McCall will serve. McCall. Give me an ace.
Moody was ready for that ball to come over, though. She was not going to let that setter have it.
McCall again. Glen Rose sets, flipping. That went wide.
Trying to go around that block.
Yeah, Flippin is 6'4", but she's had three in a row on a kill attempt that have been out. So I'll take that.
To be a fly on the wall in those huddles right now.
Well, I could. I remember back in the day when we had one. There was one game we had Tammy mic'd.
What? That should come back. I have seen some great videos of that with either umpires or athletes
yeah.
on the field.
Yeah.
That would be
yeah.
That would be something to hear.
It was a trip now. I'm
wow.
telling you. Yeah. Sixteen 13 is our score here in game number two, your Lady Pirates. hanging on right here.
You know what? Another thing that's great to see is our varsity cheerleaders out here supporting them as well.
Absolutely.
Having that cheering squad right there on the court, it really helps the mood as well.
Yeah, it does. And our student section never sits during the game. That's good stuff. Glen Rose sets it up. Wow. That was Arrington with that big hammer down. Flippin' serving here for the Lady Tigers. Set it up.
Woohoo!
Yeah.
Again, you can usually feel it from the service receive. If it's a beautiful placed service receive to the setter can just set it up beautifully.
Yep.
And then set it up for the kill.
And that was perfection right there.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
hammer time down for Sienna. Ooh. Glen Rose, tough one. They'll get it back over. Lady Parks fighting for it. That didn't work. Number one, Glen Rose was lucky to get that ball back over the net. But that's all they needed.
Yep.
17-15 now.
A point's a point.
Arrington serving here for the Lady Tigers. Back to Moody. Blum sets it up to Johnson. Johnson just a little wide.
You can see where she was trying to place it in that back corner, though.
Put it where they ain't.
Yes.
We're at a one-point game now at 17-16. It up front. Johnson will push it over. Set it up. Ball tip. McCall with a great dig. Left-handed by Blaker, of course. Set up by Anderson to return. Lady Parks at the net and the block and the point. ...18-16.
Like the girls are getting into it. They're getting a little sweaty. Got to clean up that ball.
Sure do. Petchel serving here for the Lady Pirates. Set up for Glen Rose. Down the line, and I thought that was wide.
It kind of looked like it from way up here. But man, she placed that ball on that line.
She did. That was perfect.
Probably right between the block and that pole.
Sienert with a great one. Bunt back to serve for the Lady Tigers in a one-point game. Ball put over by Johnson. Return. Blum with it to McCall. McCall back to Johnson. Not enough. We're tied at 18. By Bunt. Warrior set up. Return by Moody. Got it down. Just when they needed it, they got it done. Lady Pirates 19-18. And Kylie will go back to serve. Set it up for Glen Rose.
There they go again.
That
little play.
Sainert with another one to tie it back at 19. Anderson serving. Ball at the net by Granbury. Set it up. The return comes from Glen. Blocked by Granbury. Anderson saves. Their return comes McCall.
Beautiful.
That was Blum on the return. Anderson sets it up. Way long. And Granbury.
All right, Tammy, we got to 20.
There you go. Got it back.
All right, back at the top.
McCabe serving here for Granbury. Great save that time. What is it, a lift? I think we got a lift on that one.
You know, this is a great spot to kind of sit up here. You also get to see people from the community,
right,
and see your neighbors and wave hi to them.
Absolutely.
Little crow's nest area going on here.
McCabe does her own thing. Glen Rose keeps it alive. Pushed over by Arrington. Poirier.
Good strong hit.
Back it comes. Petchel. Back to Rachel again. Thought that had enough. Not quite. Long return. And Granbury back up by one. 21-20.
We'll take that hitting error.
Any day.
Good strong serve.
Wow. Anderson will return it. Going to be set to McCabe. Bleeker. Flipping. Never mind.
She got it in that time.
Yes, she did.
She had the power placement. That was a good hit.
Got her set up just right. Now
yep.
Glen Rose will serve in this 21-all game in game two. Gray serving for the Lady Tigers. Great job by McCabe. Might have a burnt finger, but we're all right now. Block out off of Granbury, and Glen Rose leads 22-21. Served by Glen Rose. Bleeker goes deep to get it. Going to take the ball back, and it's going to be just out by Sienna.
She was trying to place it right on that line.
Yep. Good placement, but yep. Just a little too much. It's a 23-21 Glen Rose lead. That's where we were last game, except we were ahead. Boy, this is tight. Playing going on tonight.
It's also nice to see our both sides JV team across the way supporting our girls.
Yeah, that's I love it.
Yeah. Just shows you about the difference in numbers of people, their JV team compared to ours. It's, you know.
Yeah. We're both growing.
Absolutely.
We are both growing towns.
Wow. 23-21. Sienna with the serve, with the return by Glen Rose, a block. Great save that time by Arrington. Anderson finishes it over. McCabe is going to set it up. Boom!
That was another little play by the Pirates right there, throwing off Glen Rose.
That's perfect.
Serving them kind of like their own medicine a little bit.
There you go.
A little bit. It's all right. We got
uh-huh.
this. Let's go.
You like me now. Yeah. Serve comes. Ball pushed over. Rachel is there. Bleeker. Glen Rose sets flipping with the with the touch. McCall goes deep for that one. McCabe will finish it over. Set it up to Flippin. Wow! Woo.
We're liking those quick sets right now.
That was tough to handle. Coach going to take another timeout right here. This is game point for Glen Rose.
Props to Flippin for working on her serves as well. You don't sometimes you don't see very many tall middles
right
going back to serve. Sometimes they use that for their liberos to come in and serve,
okay,
or other people like that. So props to Flippin.
Yeah, she's an all-arounder.
Yep. That's a just all-around good athlete right there.
Here we go. Game point right here.
Student section making some noise.
Flipping with the serve. Gonna set this one up to Moody. Flipping got a hand on it. Returned by Arrington. McCabe. McCabe, ball tip.
What a placement. What a placement. You know, I was even leaning forward, ready for like this huge kill.
I didn't know where you were going.
I know.
Look out, here goes Jessica. She's going to do it herself.
You got to get into the game.
Oh, of course you do. 24-23, Granbury serving. Blum. Still game point. Well, that'll do it. Wow. We beat them 25-23. They return the favor and beat us 25-23. Game three coming up on the home of Pirate Sports. Pirate Sports. All right, folks, here we go. Game number three coming up. Like Jessica said during the break, we're going to be here a while. First point goes to Glen Rose here in game number three. Duplicate scores in both games. Each one of us have one. 25-23, the outcome of both. Block, oh, what a save that time by Bleeker. Other side to Poirier. Set this one up, the ball tipped over. That's Arrington. McCall takes this, back it goes to Sienna. Wow. You don't get many kills like that.
No. It was good on her for not jumping, though. She just took a step back.
That's it.
And, you know, let the ball go over.
Perfect. Sienna leading the night with 8 kills so far.
Woo.
Whoa. That was tight.
Yeah.
Long on the kill by Sienna, and it's 2-1, Glen Rose. Flipping with the serve, it is out.
We'll take it.
Like you said earlier. McCall back to serve now for your Lady Pirates. Ball set and nice
Ooh,
job
scrappy,
by
scrappy.
Bleeker. Bleeker using her right hand. What's up with that?
Oh.
I don't know if we had a double, I'm not sure. But Glen Rose gets the points, 3-2.
Drying off the court.
That's got to do it.
You don't want anybody slipping and injuring themselves.
No. I'm going to be taking care of my injury that I had in high school here coming up in a few months.
Oh, are you?
My ankle replacement.
Oh, man.
Not fun.
Was it a repeated injury or just a single big blow?
It was a big blow, but I had several after that.
Mm.
But not like that one. Mm. Bleeker got it down.
Powering through that block. You know, I know a thing or two about ankle injuries, but not that big.
Yeah.
Coach Rhodes always doctoring me down there.
But such thing back, you know, I'm talking in the 60s. Yeah, you blew out your ankle. Here's some ice and crutches.
Right.
You'll be back in a couple of weeks.
Try a couple of decades.
Wow, that was out. That was out.
That was close.
Mighty close. He called it out here on the line, and Granbury has creeped back into the lead now, 4-3.
Some basketball girls walking by?
Well, that would be, hang on just a second, we'll get, look Ooh. At all this net play, this is crazy. Good job by Blum to save that one. McCall, Bleeker with the lefty. Blocked by Granbury. Oh, beautiful. Oh, are you serious?
Wow.
What a return. Johnson got it. Blocked down and blocked good. Sainert got that one to tie it at 4. That was Allie and Ella, a couple of the Lady Pirate basketball players. We'll be calling their names for very long. Allie, a dual sport athlete. She's softball pitcher and plays basketball. Moody, 4-4 here, game 3. Longman McCall Wow, one-hander sent a long way that time by Rachel. Rachel again got it close. Johnson returns it. Set this one up for Glen Rose. Blocked at the net. And we'll take it. Petchel is serving here for the Lady Pirates. Okay. That.
Right smack dab in the middle.
Another one of the best that I ever saw doing that was a young lady by the name of Aubrey Ezell. Did you remember Aubrey Ezell? Were you already gone when Aubrey was here?
For volleyball?
Yeah.
I was.
Okay.
I was gone. But my sister, Crystal, she may have.
Yeah. Yeah, Aubrey.
Been around that time.
She was a master at that deception pass, right? Like that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, mercy. Right back at it. That was flipping on that one. 6-5, Glen Rose. Anderson with the serve. Set up, blocked by Granbury. Blocked by Glen Rose. Doubled up on that one. Seven, five. Blum will set it up. We'll do it again for Rachel. Anderson gonna set this up, push over that time. Goes by Seiner. Moody. Anderson. McCall on the back line. Blum's gonna set this one up. Back, block.
Well, that's a good strong block.
Yeah, that's one thing 6'4" will do for you.
Absolutely. And it looked like our girls were tight around the hit, but she just had a nice strong block and it went pretty straight down.
And this is the biggest lead, I think, that that Glen Rose has had all night. They're up 8-5 right now in this game number three. I remember a 6'4" girl we had here. Maddie, Lefty. You don't remember Lefty? Okay. Maddie Miller. Had some incredible players over there, Jessica. My gosh. Of course, your sister went on and played in college.
Yes. Dallas Baptist.
So many. I mean, you know, of course, Aubrey played 4 years at South Carolina. Karis Beasley played at Auburn.
Oh, wow.
Of course, There's so many of them that just kind of run together. Amber Strange. Set all kinds. I think she set every record at Charlton. She's coaching now in Corsicana.
Good for her. Continuing her career in volleyball.
That's it. Moody.
Ooh.
That was a hot shot.
You know, another great athlete was Lauren Fleming back in my day playing volleyball and basketball.
And it's that is so hard to do because they're so completely different, but she never missed a lick. She was amazing.
Going straight from volleyball to basketball, that's tough. You don't get a break at all.
Yeah, I know it.
Sometimes even doubling up.
Yeah, we've had a few do that over the years. Amber did that. Of course, back in the day with Emily Britt and Sarah McBroom did that back in the day. Long on the return, Glen Rose up 10-6. Set by Granbury. Return comes from Dowling. Glen Rose flipping. Ball returned. Anderson. And long on that return, and it's 10-7.
Looks like they brought McCabe in a little early and had her play in the front row for a little bit, kind of switching things up.
That's a little different. McCabe serving now for Granbury. Lady Parts trailing by three. McCall got a hand on that one. Sienna. Sienna again. McCabe puts it up. Poirier puts it over. Glenrose sets. Wow. Arrington. 11-7 now.
McCall tried to get to it.
Back serving is Gray here. Granbury trailing by four. Rachel McCabe. Not enough there. Good job that time.
Poirier was coming in hot on that one.
That's Rachel with her fourth of the night. Needed that one. Glen Rose had a four-pointer going into that one. Poirier with the serve.
Good serve.
Anderson. Return from Glen Rose. Not enough.
Let's capitalize on this. Let's get it going.
Get those points back. That's, boy, these have been two very, very close matches so far. Third one shown to be the same. Wow, way up on the McCabe.
Good dig.
Sienna. Anderson sets it up to Arrington. McCabe got a hand up on that one. Bleeker with a long one. Anderson. Block.
Nice big block.
Calling got up on that one. Lady Pirates, a three-point run here. Rachel serves again, but long.
A little too much power behind that. You know, another thing that both teams have been pretty good at is setting up from far back in the back row. They don't just let those go to free balls. They set up to kill.
Right, absolutely. 12-10, Glen Rose flipping serves again. McCabe, McCall will finish it. Flipping, set it up, ball pushed over, and up over the block. Nobody to retrieve from the back, and Glen Rose back by three now. 13-10.
Poirier tried. She laid out to try to get that up.
Bleeker has it blocked. Still in action, but not enough. And Glen Rose now by four. Equaling their biggest lead.
Adjusting our service receive. Switching things up. Let's break this serve.
Flipping. McCall will have to go long for that. She did. McCabe finishes. Glen Rose. Wow. Arrington on a roll, as are the Lady Tigers right now. Flippin serving again. Return. Oh.
I don't know what they call that nowadays, but I definitely know back in the day we called them birthdays.
Happy birthday. Absolutely. Yeah. In fact, I had Lefty come in and join me a game a couple of years ago, and somebody did that, and she went, "Happy birthday." And I went, and she said, "That's what you sell." That's why I have you guys come in and help me, because I don't know about this. Y'all do. I love it. Return is long. Wow.
Little adjustment on the call there. Can be frustrating at times, but he's calling what he saw.
17-10. This is the biggest lead by either team.
You know, you can really see the girls getting tired, but they really got to pull through here.
McCabe's going to set this up. Block back and block out.
Whenever there's a big block in front of you, you really can't be scared and back away from it. You have to power through it.
That was a huge play by Sienna. Yes. McCall with the serve. Give us an ace.
Let's get this ball rolling. Let's go.
Get them points back really quick. Serve by McCall. Ball to, oh my goodness. That was sneaky now.
That was well, and I think that was a little bit more of adjustment on Glen Rose's part, but they still were able to pull through.
Well, they did.
And it also faked us out.
Yeah, it sure did. 18-12, Glen Rose, McCall, McCabe, Sienna.
She was there.
What a save, my goodness. Ball tipped over. McCall cannot quite get it there in Glen Rose. Lady Pirates going to take another timeout.
You know, this 7-point lead, these girls really have to break past that mental block.
They got to.
Block.
Got to now.
They
got to
power through it. I know they're tired. I know they're tired. They really have to push through and really get the second half of this game going.
Certainly do. This is, there hadn't been a run like this by either team, so.
No. Good for Glen Rose. But let's go, Lady Pirates. Come on.
Let's do it. That's what I'm saying. Well, we want to remind everybody, on Friday night, Granbury football travels to Lake Worth, and your Lady Pirates are traveling to Cleburne for volleyball. And then next week on Tuesday, the Lady Pirates are traveling to Abilene Wiley for a duel. And then, of course, they will open district play next Friday, on Homecoming Friday, against Saginaw. And of course, your Granbury Pirates homecoming football next Friday, taking on Waco Lions.
It'd be great to see some of the homecoming crowd come support their Lady Pirates and then make their way to the game.
You got it. Served by Glen Rose. McCall goes deep, not able to get anything on it.
You know, I didn't see any top serve on that ball. That must have been a floater. Those floater balls really move throughout the air, and you're not sure exactly where it's going to come to hit your arms.
Serve. McCall. Moody. Glen Rose. The return. What a nice save. Ball tipped over by Moody. Ball punch. McCabe again. McCall now set it up. Going to set it up for Bleeker. Bleeker made it happen.
Like I said before, these girls are not backing away from those Glen Rose girls, from that block. They're powering through. Good for them.
That's number 8 for Bleeker. 2013 Lady Pirates. Got a hill to climb here. Tried another one, and we were there for that. McCabe, Moody. Glen Rose will set it up. Not enough. Lady Pirates, another point.
Moody was ready, but it looked like Glen Rose headed into the net.
Ball's going to be set up to Glen Rose. Into the net it goes. And here comes the Lady Pirates. 3 straight points. Glen Rose going to take a timeout.
You know, another thing that I see with these Lady Pirates is that their serves are pretty consistent. You can really count on them.
Yes, you can. Absolutely.
And that comes from hard work and lots of practice, repeating that same serve, and then getting more confident and adding more power behind it as well.
Play that stuff, Shayhan.
See, see some people in the crowd kind of nodding their head, getting into it.
They like it. That's fine. Five-point game here in game number three. We are tied at one. Serve by Blum. Set up. Wow. That was out of the house.
That must have come off her hand wrong.
Now it's a four-point game.
Keep it up, Blum.
Serve again by Blum.
Good placement.
Glen Rose. Block. Boy, not enough. Just off the fingertips. No backup. Glen Rose 21-16.
Getting those kills not only in the front row, but the back row as well.
Bunt will serve here for the Lady Tigers. Blum will set it up to McCabe. McCabe over to Moody. Bunt with it. The tip over. Blum there again. Wow.
Middle was ready.
That came so quick.
Was that Booth?
Yes, it was. Yes, it was. Booth with the quick hands.
She's watching her. She's making sure those sneaky little sets over don't come.
22-16 comes to Bleeker. Nice. Bleeker again.
Again, just powering through that block.
And Bleeker has broken service twice now for the Lady Pirates with a kill. Petchel serving now for Granbury. Ball tipped over to McCall waiting for it. McCabe takes it to Rachel. Glen Rose will play on. Blocked by Granbury. Jump ball goes to Granbury. Granbury. 22-18. Lady Pirates creeping up the charts.
Glen Rose not really liking that call.
Block, little block on it by Granbury. McCabe sets it up. Moody, way back, not going to get to it. And the Lady Pirates are within three. We've got a little extra charge. I've been listening to you, Jessica.
They're bringing it back. Let's keep this fire going.
Petchel serves. Miscommunication. It's a two-point game.
Let's capitalize on this. Glen Rose coming together, trying to.
Well, they'll take a timeout now. 22-20. It was a seven-point lead by Glen Rose just a second ago, but great comeback by your Lady Pirates.
Coming in, closing that gap. Really got to keep this rolling after this timeout.
Well, now, when you graduated high school, did you go play?
I did not.
Okay.
No, I didn't continue playing. I really did miss the competitiveness, but I did go on to Dallas Baptist University.
Right.
And then I finished out my degree later at Tarleton State.
Hey, go Texans.
Yeah.
That's where my degree's from, so.
Yep.
Fellow Texans right up here.
Yeah. Heck, and you don't have to change colors, purple to purple.
That's it. How convenient.
All right, let's go Petchel.
Petchel serving, two-point game. McCall. McCabe finishes. Oh,
wow.
Yeah!
What? A point on a sneaky free ball to that middle spot.
How about that?
Woo.
22-21. Petchel serves again. All set up. Tipped by Granbury. Rachel. Glen Rose on the return. Tips it over. Got a handle on that one. McCabe will return. Glen Rose sets it up. Ball blocked by Granbury. The return.
The ball went into the net. We didn't get a hand on that block.
No, they didn't. We are tied at 22. What an amazing comeback by your Lady Pirates. 22-22.
Glen Rose started off this game really, really strong, and Granbury's really finally starting to answer back.
Petchel serves again. Going to be a toe. Moody! Back it goes. Petchel got a hand on it. It goes to Moody. Rachel, too short. Wow. 23-22.
You know, seeing some of these dads back here, yeah. I remember my dad doing the same thing for my sister.
Rachel. Flipping. Well, she hadn't been in a while, but now we see why.
She came to answer.
Big shot. This is game point right here.
Sometimes it's hard to adjust, especially someone taller coming
right in.
You have to adjust your block timing.
Especially coming from that high over the net.
Yes, you really do.
Be set up to Moody, it's blocked. Moody again. Oh, yeah! Kylie Moody!
Finding a little sweet spot.
24-23, Lady Pirates trail by one. Again, game point for Glen Rose. Flipping, Moody on the back line, McCabe sets it to Rachel. Anderson with the save, Glen Rose pushes it. What did we get a look?
So what happened was the outside hitter hit the ball on the outside of the pole.
Okay.
The pole lines up with the lines for the volleyball court.
Okay.
And so the ball did go into the court, but it was on the outside of the pole when hit it.
We are tied at 24. You got to win by two, remember. McCabe will set it up.
Oh, she wanted that. She wanted that.
Just too much on it. And it's Glen Rose back on top, 25-24. Game point again.
Service received. Let's go. Get this first ball.
McCabe will set it up. Other side for Rachel. Flipping. I guess a lift? Okay. Wow.
Well, they called the lift.
We played three games. Each one of them have been by 2 points. Glen Rose leads 2-1. Game four coming up. And welcome back, game four here from the James Wan Sports Center. Lita Andrews Court. Granbury and Glen Rose playing some tight volleyball tonight. I'm, of course, joined by Jessica Burke, former Lady Park volleyball player. First point goes to Siena.
I really hope those girls got some rest.
Yeah.
It's like you said before, it's going to be a long one.
You're going to the max on all three games here. This has been a grueling battle for both teams. Make that 2-0. Rachel Poirier serving here. Other side. Oh my goodness. McCall. What a save with your face.
You know that's got to sting a little bit.
Oh, mercy. That does. But for it to come off of her and get a play out of it.
Yes. Libero through and through.
I'm telling you. 2-1 now. Outside is Granbury. McCabe will finish and bring it back. Set this to flipping. Yeah, 2-2. Granbury won the first one 25-23. Glen Rose won the next one 25-23. And they won the third one 26-24. Yeah, we're evened up here tonight, I'm telling you. Sienna Watts. Sienna now up to 11 in kills on the night. Anderson will get it on back. McCabe to McCall. Take this to Bleeker, block back. Big blocker out there at 6'4". That's flipping, and she will go back and serve for Glen Rose. Not her strong point. McCall, McCabe sets it.
And there's fire behind that one.
And Sienna finishes it again. She's up to 12 now. Serve is long, and we're tied at 4.
When that adrenaline's flowing, sometimes it's hard to really bring that in.
Oh, yeah. You never had that problem, did you? All right.
More out than in the net, I would say.
All right. Block back, boy. Wow. 5-4 Glen Rose.
My dad would always tell me, just hit the broad side of the barn.
Hit the broad side of the barn.
Which is easy to say.
Yeah.
But that's difficult.
McCabe, Bleeker. There you go, Bleeker.
Because most of the time, these girls are aiming for certain players whenever they're serving. They're just not trying to aim for the whole court. They're aiming. They have strategic planning in their serve, whether or not it's a floater, a top spin, going to a certain player.
Okay. Return comes from Glen Rose. Blum got it. Cannot get enough of it. And it's 6-5 now, Glen Rose.
Looked like McCabe was worried about running into her teammate.
I know.
You don't want to tackle a teammate and trying to go after the ball.
William serving for Glen Rose. McCabe, Ball tipped over by Moody. Glen Rose saves it. McCall McCabe. Back to Rachel. Tough one. Fisted it over. McCabe's going to set it up for Moody, and it's too long. 7-5. Bunt now serving for the Lady Tigers. McCabe sets to Rachel and put it down.
Again, with a good pass, set, hit. It takes teamwork to make those dreamy kills.
A lot of time on the practice court. 7-6 now, Granbury serving. Kylie Moody back to serve for your Lady Pirates. Long one, back it goes to Moody again. McKay, Blum, too long. 8-6, Glen Rose.
It's good to see the girls come together for Blum to say, it's okay, we got this next point.
Right, ain't no doubt, yep. Teammates, baby, it's what it's about. Oh, man.
You know, those are so hard.
No, I hate them.
And you know, both sides of the cheering is just leaning on the side, on the edge of their seats, hoping which way for it to go over.
Blocked back by Granbury, but Rachel was there to keep it going. Flipping down with it. And it's 10-6. Serve is out. We will take it. 10-7 now, Glen Rose here in game four. Thanks for joining us here on this Tuesday night on the Pirate Sports Network on YouTube.
Good serve.
Flipping. Just kind of flipped it over there. Return that time by Watts. Wow. Sunert set up so well. Sunert, excuse me. 11-7 Glen Rose. Back it goes. McCabe sets it up over here again for Siena. Siena racking them up. She's got 13 kills now tonight. Puts her up to about 190 on the year. Oh. 11-8. Takes to Flippin. And Flippin scores again.
That's an awkward placement for the ball for McCabe. Just right out of her chest, and it's coming super fast towards you. You have to make a split decision whether or not you're going to pass it or set it. Or just let it hit off the palms of your hands.
Right. Glen Rose serving again, leading by four. McCabe sets this up again. It is Siena. Arrington on that one. McCabe back to Siena again. Has a tip. Anderson saves it. McCabe got that one to McCall. Bleeker goes long. Fire. 13-8 Glen Rose. Gray serves again, was
good
it?
Serve.
That was a line driver. Pushed it quickly over, but Anderson waited for it. Left-hander is tipped by Granbury. And out. And Coach Shahan's going to take a timeout, a 6-point difference here at 14-8. Well, now, as far as Lady Pirate volleyball is concerned, because of how the scheduling is going to be going, they've got a lot of away games and home games. But now, coming up I think we're going to get Jessica to join me again on the 26th of September. That won't be, we won't have another broadcast till September. That is crazy.
Wow. Yeah, if you'll have me again, I'd love to come out. Maybe it'll be cooler outside too once we get there.
Golly, I'm so tired of this. You know, we're excited about 98 degrees.
You know? No, really.
I know.
This week, I know we went outside today just for a little bit. With some of our kids for a testing break.
Yeah.
And you should have heard some of the teachers praise the cloud cover for like
right?
5 minutes.
Yeah. Well, I know it. It has been brutal. And another thing, my wife and I have an above ground pool at the house, and the water has been at 92 at times, 92 degrees. We got in it earlier today, and it was 82 degrees, and
cold.
Didn't last long, but still, when you first got in it, you're thinking, my gosh. Well, mercy. Sienna is on a tear. That's 14 so far. And that is our score at 14-9, Lady Pirates trailing. McCall will go back to serve. Glen Rose recovers and flip and finishes. McCabe sets it up to Sienna again. Glen Rose back, waits for it. Other side, the tip.
Oh.
Mercy.
Well, McCabe laid out for that one, though. She really tried to pop that up in time.
And, but you know, it was a smart play over there by Arrington because you got two blockers right in your face. And she
strong
just,
blockers.
Just went up and over and got it down. 15-9 now. Flipping serves again off of Rachel. Moody. Nice job that time by McCabe, and that's going to go out. Sienna couldn't quite get to it, and it's 16-9. It's about the time that the Lady Pirates started working their way back in, because it's a 7-point lead. It's about time to get that going.
Yes.
McCabe tips it over. That's a great play that time by Poirier.
That pass was a little close to the net. So good on McCabe for getting it out a little bit and for the hitter to make the adjustment.
Yes. That was a great play. 16-10 now. Just what the doctor ordered. Need more of that. Got a little moisture on the court.
Safety comes first. A little cheer war going on there.
I know it. It's fun, isn't it? Nice save that time by Blum. She will send it over. Set up. Block back down, Lady Pirates. Kaboom, Moody.
That'll pump anybody up right there. Let's go.
Great play by Kylie at the front. 16-11, Lady Pirates down. Anderson set this one up. No, into the net. 16-12, here we go.
You know, it may have been in the net, but Moody was there. She was ready. She saw that play, and she was ready for that second hitter to come and swing.
Blum to serve again. Glen Rose trying to sneak one in. Didn't happen that time. Good play by Bleeker to get that over the net. Not enough. Still not enough. And it's a 3-point game.
Looked like that outside hitter was really trying to get a good angle.
Yeah.
On that outside hit to find it, but it looked like it was too much angle.
Overthunk it.
Yeah.
Blum serving. Granbury trailing 16-13 now. Set it up. Well, that's a, she's done that a couple of times tonight. That was Booth with a smart play. Glen Rose back up by four now at 17-13.
Our student section trying to really pump up our girls.
Good save that time by McCabe. McCall will get it over. Little trying to work a little trickeration. Didn't work that time. Bleeker. Bleeker again. Bleeker with 11 tonight. 17-14. Lady Pirates ain't going nowhere. Petchel serving. Glen Rose the tip. McCall back there to get it. Rachel Anderson has it for Glen Rose. Ball tipped over. Petchel saves. She'll send it back. It comes back to her, but McCall got it. Petchel sends it back over. Glen Rose setting it up. Here they come. Nobody got it.
Seemed like Glen Rose didn't know who that was going to go to. They were both trying to grab it and save it.
Little confusion there, but 17-15.
Let's go, Lady Pirates.
McCall don't digging deep for that one. Moody sends it over. Glen Rose a long one. It is too long. It's a one-point game.
That was a good, quick read on McCall.
Wow.
Seeing that that fastball was going out, and by, not by much. So that was a good read on McCall.
It certainly was. Just a minute ago, this was a seven-point Glen Rose lead, and now the Lady Pirates have fought back to make it a one-pointer. This has been some amazing volleyball tonight, Jessica. Good night.
It really
night.
Has. I'm glad I've been here tonight. Thanks for inviting me.
Without a doubt. Yeah, we'll get you back at in about a month from now, actually. So I'm going to turn out. But yeah, we've got... The problem is, on foot, we have a couple to work. We have a football and a volleyball game on the same night at the same place, like here. So what we try to do is on Pirate Sports Network, they'll at least stream the volleyball game live and then join football for the kickoff at 7. So
that's good to know. That's really good to know.
Because
you can catch the game on your phone
yes.
and still, you know.
Right. We have tried it before back in the day to do both.
You
and we got caught.
You mean you can't be two places at once?
I tried that. It didn't work. No. Set up by Glen Rose. McCall, nice save. Over to Blum. Petchel finishes it back over. Anderson going to be setting up. Long one. We're tied.
Let's get this run.
17-17. What a battle. Ooh, boy. I didn't think that was going to make it.
Yep. And they didn't.
Lady Pirates, a run and a half. 18-17, Granbury. Petchel serves again. Glen Rose, the left-hander, boom. Wow.
Good answer. By Winston?
Winslow.
Oh, Winslow, yeah. I think
her
sister played up with me.
That's right.
Up here at Granbury High School.
That's cool.
It's cool to see siblings that far apart still have a love for the same sport.
You know it. 18-18 now. McCabe sets it back, a little off balance, but still got the ball over. Return comes from the Lady Tigers. Set it up to Rachel. Tipped at the net. Glen Rose sets it up. And Granbury leads 19-18. This is unbelievable. What a turnaround.
The girls really showing their true colors
really
and grit.
Are.
Coming back from a
huge deficit.
Yes.
Long serve. Well, it's going to... Glen Rose fighting for it. Wow. Rachel McKay back over to Rachel. And again, Granbury 20-18.
Girls having a little fun on the court celebrating that one.
They should.
Coming together as a team. It's always great to see.
Moody serving. McKay will set it up for Rachel. Good save by Glen Rose. Ball sent over by Sienert. Rachel again sent it too long. 20-19. Anderson will serve here for the Lady Tigers. Granbury gets it done. That was Cowling that came in, and Granbury 21-19. Long serve, strong one. Set this up for Flippin.
She was ready.
Yep. She had her spot picked out, too.
Oh, exactly.
21-20. Sienert with the serve. Rachel, back it on the back line. Set it up. Ball tipped over. And we're 21. Arrington's a good player, number 10. 21-21.
A little miscommunication
there. Yeah,
there
was, yeah. Just a little bit, yeah. 22-21, Glen Rose. Another timeout. Wow. But don't forget, they'll have the Granbury Park football game coming up on Friday night from Lake Worth. I'm not going to be able to make it. I'll go take care of some family things up in Wichita Falls, but I'll be back next week for homecoming. But we'll still have the live stream of Park football coming from Lake Worth. Great start for Granbury Park football with a 43-12 win over Carrollton Creekview. So unusual to see this day and age in football, Jessica. Granbury runs the ball.
Really?
They had over 400 yards rushing. And all you see today is people in the spread, you know, four receivers. But it was cool to see, you know, kind of a throwback.
Right.
It worked for Granbury. Here we go, Glen Rose 22-21. Rachel puts it over. Sets it for Flippin. Out, and it's 23-21. Cedar serving again. Petchel, McCabe, ball tip, not enough.
When the ball is that close to the net, it's kind of hard to tip around. You really.
No kidding.
It's even harder to go up and over, especially a tall block like that.
This is match point right here. McCabe, ball tip, out, and that's going to do it. I tell you what, Jessica, four amazing volleyball games tonight. I mean, 25-21 was our biggest. For everything else was 2 points difference, but what a great night it was.
It was a fantastic game. I am so thankful to be able to witness that. It was incredible.
It was. Jessica Burke, thank you so much for tonight. This is David Euchre for the Pirate Sports Network on YouTube. September 26th, you're back in the house for Lady Pirate Volleyball. Thank you so much. Y'all have a great night tonight. Pirate football on Friday night, 7 o'clock. Be there or be square. Euchre is O-U-T out.